yeah. Shaba, yeah. That's the one, yeah. That's the one I need. Yeah, bring it over here, yeah. You know? You know? You know we always thinking about things in life, you know? Yeah, you know? There's a few good brothers I know that prove themselves. Yeshaba and Portia. You know? Once you get good people in your corner, make sure you never let them go and deal with them right, you know? Because good things are hard to come by, especially in these times, you know? When I came to the realization of who we are and how we used to be in the ancient world, I cried internally. Life is supposed to be based upon loving, caring, sharing, respect, living and giving, as well as receiving. We diverted from brotherly love to a big pot of mess. I considered all these things. As a nation, we have really messed up, damn. But one day the hour shall change. But one day the hour shall change. But one day the hour shall change.
Peace and blessings, my brothers and sisters. This is your brother, Prince Zion Yisrael, once again. And today we want to touch on some basic fundamentals pertaining to our heritage, pertaining to our family that's scattered throughout North, Central, and South America, as well as the so-called Native American Indians. This is not for those who already know. This is basically for those who don't know. Many of you have heard this already. And by the way, this is a picture of one of our so-called Cherokee sisters. Don't quite know the name that they gave this brother in this picture, but to make it simple and plain, we all come from the same nation. Basically, we're just divided up, and our mind has been contaminated with a lot of falsehood identity. Because there's no such thing as Native American Indians. There's no such thing as Dominicans, Puerto Ricans, Jamaicans, Haitian, Panamanians, Cubans, Mexicans, so-called Afro-Americans, so on and so forth. Even white people. These are all false identities that was forced into our minds when we went into captivity and slavery. You will not find no nation in the ancient world identified as Cherokees, Blackfoots, Seminoleans, Haitians, Jamaicans, Panamanians, Cubans, Mexicans. This is all falsehood. And this is a curse that came upon us due to the fact of our great disrespect against the Most High Creator. Some say the Great Spirit. Some say Yeshua. Some say Yahweh. But that is not the issue of the matter, my brothers and sisters. But the Almighty Creator of the universe will one day clear up this confusion. But the issue of the matter is described in the book of Daniel, chapter 9, verse 7. And it states this: O Lord, O Creator, O Great Spirit, righteousness belongeth unto thee, because the Creator of the universe is a righteous power. But unto us confusion of faces. What is the confusion of faces? Some of us think we're better than each other. Some of us think that we're really Dominicans. That's the confusion of faces. Some of us think that there is a such people as Puerto Ricans. What else is the confusion of faces? A lot of us think that is something wrong with having dark skin complexion. What else is the confusion of faces? These different, diverse, cursed languages that we are speaking here today. Part of our family is speaking what they call Spanish, which was forced on them by the conqueror, evil, wicked Spaniards. Some of us are speaking French, which was forced on them by the French enemies. Some of us are speaking English. Some of us are speaking Portuguese. Daniel chapter 9, verse 7. O Creator, righteousness belongeth unto thee, but unto us confusion of faces. And the confusion that's inside our face, we've been taught that we are different than each other. We all come from the same nation. But we must keep in mind, like it says in 1 Corinthians chapter 3:19, that the wisdom of this world is foolishness. And that foolish wisdom we have been taught. 99% of the things that we have been taught in this society is based upon lies. From our identity, from our language, from our customs, the way we eat, and even the true understanding that the Creator gave us pertaining to what marriage is. Because this is not marriage. This is a bunch of chaos and confusion That's why the courthouse is always filled up with our people getting divorces. But let's get down to the nitty-gritty of the matter. And this is not for the brothers and sisters that do know this. This is for the brothers and sisters that don't know. Now, I got this off the internet. And a lot of these 16th and even prior to the 19th century, a lot of historians, okay, during that time, used to settle among the tribe of our ancestors. And they recorded their customs. And they recorded their way of living. Before the Spaniard invasion, before that Spanish tongue was forced on you, before the name Dominicano, Puerto Rican, Ecuadorian, Peruvian was forced on you, just like the so-called Afro-American false identity was forced on the brothers and sisters in America, as well as Cherokee, so on and so forth. But for understanding's sake, let's deal with this issue of the matter. If you type in Taino Indian spiritual ceremony, this information might come up if it's still available. And it states this. Are the ancestors of the indigenous people that populated the Americas descendants of the lost tribe of Israel? Accordingly to many highly regarded and reputable 6th through 19th century scholars, historians, linguists, and archaeologists, yes, they are. Such as this Spaniard by the name of Francisco who went down to Peru. And this is what he had to say about the so-called Peruvian brothers. And this came from a book called Lost Tribes of the Promised Land by the author Ronald Saunders. And it states, in Peru, in the 1560s and 70s, a Dominican friar called Francisco Le da Cruz had declared himself the Messiah, which is a lie, of a new world, talking about where the Peruvian brothers are dwelling and sisters here today, of a new world, Christianity, which is falsehood, because the Creator gave us laws to live by. Christianity is made by man to enslave us, which had to fight a war to the death against the Indians, which is a false identity, in order to bring on the final redemption, because they were the lost tribes of Israel. Now, here's a picture of one of our Peruvian, so-called Peruvian, Afro-Peruvian sister that is suffering here today. Now, keep in mind, my brothers and sisters, what we just read. And by the way, this is another one of our so-called Afro-Peruvian sisters. Remember what we just read from the book Lost Tribe of the Promised Land, pertaining to this, what they call Dominican friar by the name of Francisco de la Cruz, how he stated that our ancestors that were living in Peru, who they went down to conquer and to put in slavery, he identified them as the lost tribe of Israel. For what reason? Because they were speaking a Hebrew tongue. Because they came from the Middle East before the Spanish language was forced on them, just like the prophecy Isaiah chapter 65, my brothers and sisters, verse 15 states that ye shall leave your name for a curse. What is that curse? This falsehood identity, such as Peruvian. This falsehood identity, such as Jamaican, Haitian, Uruguay, Panamanian, Mexican, so-called Afro-American. That's the curse. Ye shall leave your name for a curse. And the language that we speak in is a curse. There's no honor in identifying ourselves with the Spaniards. It's just a ball of confusion because we went against the grain of the Most High's principles. Just like it states in the book of James chapter 1 verse 1 to the 12, talking about you Peruvian brothers and sisters, you Afro-Mexican brothers and sisters, you so-called Dominican brothers and sisters, to the 12 that are scattered abroad. Scattered all throughout North, Central, and South America, and America, Spain, England, London. Some of us are living in Germany. There's a book called Columbus, His Enterprise by Hans Kung. It states that Columbus was a Jew, which is a lie. This is a false identity that Spain made up for themselves as well, just like they made up a false identity for all of us as well. Columbus was a Jew looking for the lost tribes of Israel. You see, they knew who they were conquering, and Isabella and them were fully acquainted with the prophecy of 2 Ezra chapter 13, verse 40, how a fraction of our family was going to migrate over to North, Central, South America and the so-called Native American Indians to America, because we've been traveling back and forth ever since the ancient days of times. I know that's hard for a lot of people to understand, because we've been dumbed down to a very low level. Like it says in 2 Ezra chapter 13, verse 40. These are the 10 tribes which were carried away prison out of their own land in the time of Hosea. This is over in the Middle East, because everything started in the Middle East, by the way. The king whom Salmaneser, the king of Assyria, led away captives, and he carried them over the waters, and so came they into another land, as it is today, North, Central, and South America. So let's continue. Okay, where we left off at the very beginning, pertaining to this this write-up on the Tainos and all the brothers and sisters in North, Central, and South America, and the so-called Native American Indians. And it states this: for hundreds of years, many theories as to the origins of the indigenous people that once populated, and for the most part still, the Americas and the Caribbean islands, have been debated by the scholarly minded. Today, they are called Latinos. Why I say today they are called Latinos? Because that's a false identity. Hispanics, that's a false identity. Puerto Ricans, rich port, false identity. There's no such people. Dominicans, that's a false identity. Colombians, that's a false identity. Indians, there is no such people in the ancient world. And we are a descendant of the people of the ancient world. Most of these names were placed upon them by the European nations, by the conquerors, the Spaniards, by force, which conquered them, which is still up to today. All these labels, that's all Afro-American is, a label, that's all Dominican is, it's a false label, which were placed upon them, are inaccurate, because this is not who the creator of the universe created us to be. This is a curse of judgment that came upon us because we went against his laws, rules, and regulations. It says, inaccurate perception of the identity or ancient origins of these people, learning and religious, which is something that they made up, institution, which they made up to destroy our minds, as well as the media, which broadcast lies all over the world, which broadcast lies, have taught inaccurate facts and a distorted picture of self, just like this fake thing called Christianity with the false images, to these people. That's why people are brainwashed. That's why the Puerto Ricans think they're different than the Dominicans. That's why there's confusion between the Spanish tribes as well as the so-called Afro-American tribe over here today, because a lot of us are brainwashed over here as well. This has been done in an effort to keep these indigenous, so-called indigenous people in utter darkness. And this is nothing but total darkness. How are you going to follow the fake religion of the people that chopped your ancestors' heads off and raped your ancestors? And then we, as the offspring of that bloodline, we come and embrace their false fake religion. It said to keep the indigenous people into utter darkness of their true place in the world structure. If the means of this animating information that I mentioned above would come out, which it is one day, with an inkling of the issue that we are about to bring forth, it would have a dramatic change in the world, because most of the world is living in darkness today. Many of the citizens of the world have been kept in ignorance, including you so-called white people as well, to the true origins, because you have a false identity. There's no such people known as white people in the ancient world as well. As to the true origin of these so-called Latin, why he says so-called? Because this is falsehood, and Indian nations especially the very same Latinos who have some Indian bloodline and Indians themselves. And we can add the so-called Black American into that picture too as well, because we ran into their villages for refuge and we intermarried with them, for those that know the true history. My goal with this site is to lift this veil of ignorance, because this whole world is dealing with ignorance and confusion and lies. That's why everybody, well, the majority of the people, are bugged out of their mind from so much false information. My goal with this site is to lift this veil of ignorance that has compassed the world, especially my brothers and sisters of the indigenous and Hispanic communities, so-called. Just like Revelation chapter 12, verse 9 states, it says, the devil and Satan wish to deceive the whole world. It's a ball of confusion. That's why it states this. Let us continue. It said, during the 16th, all the way up to the 19th century, many historians and scholars of these eras have come to the conclusion as to the origin of the natives that they had encountered. Just like James Adair, he spent 40 years among the Native American Indians, so-called, and he recorded their customs, and he recorded their language, and he came to this conclusion that these people came from the Middle East, okay, before this so-called Western society, falsehood, lies, propaganda, that have brainwashed the people out of their cultures for so many years. It was done by force, and then it was done by many other crafty tactics. It said, the conclusion as to the origin of the natives that they had encountered, talking about the historians of the 16th to the 19th century, the Spaniards, that they had encountered in the Western Hemisphere after an intense study. You see, they studied our history. They investigated the matter. They didn't took things according to face value. They didn't go accordingly to he say, she say. Some of them traveled down in the land of Peru and the Dominican Republic and Puerto Rico and other parts of South America, as well as America. And they recorded what they saw. And this is what they wrote, what they saw. And they tried to publicize this information, but Spain did not want to promote it. Let us continue, brothers and sisters, pertaining to these Spaniard 16th to 19th century historians and scholars and archaeologists and them doing their intense studying and astounding archaeological finds. They came to the conclusion that these natives, so-called, were indeed members of the long-lost nation of Israel. Their mannerism, their religious, which mean their customs, and no such thing as religion. Like we said before, it's a made-up word, come from the word religio, which means to keep back, hold down, restrain, and to confine. Their mannerism, this is what they saw. Their customs, their language, which was not Spanish or Portuguese until it was forced on them. And fashion of dress, meaning their dress code, was strong implication as to the Hebraic origin of these aborigines, such as this 19th century picture of this Navajo brother. Look at his dress code. This is a Middle East dress code. Okay? Look at his fringes. And when you read Numbers chapter 15, and you read from verse 38 to verse 41, it describes exactly what this dress code is pertaining to, and the fringes represents a symbol that represents the laws and the commandments and the statutes that the Creator originally gave us to live by. And on his chest, you see the Shield of David, or rather what they call the Shield of David. But let me zoom in. Yeah, let me zoom in here for this so you can get a little closer view. Look at that. And then go read Numbers, the 15th chapter, from 38 to verse 41. This is no other than an ancient Hebraic dress code. You see, when they came down to what they call Latin America here today, this is what they saw. This is what was down there. Our ancestors. This is what was going on. And when they came over to what they call North America, which is known as America here today, or rather Southeast America, and this is a picture going back to 1858, this is what they saw. One of our ancestors, which they call here today the Native American Indians, which they suppressed these images before the rape and the rob and the murder and the butchering up and the so-called Native American Indian and the so-called Black Afro-American, they knew that they were related. Okay, we were not brainwashed like we are here today because we used to run in their villages for refuge, and it wasn't like that we became friends. No, we knew we came from the same nation. It's just that the historians, the way they explain the situation of the matter in their distorted history books, they explain it with a big fat lie. This came from that Black Indian book. Look at that. That's supposed to represent the so-called Negro, and that's supposed to represent the so-called Native American brethren. But this generation is really brainwashed here today, and the curse is really hardcore on our minds. Like it says in Hebrews chapter 13, verse 1, let brotherly love continue. Our past ancestors, which they classified as Native American Indians, so-called Negroes, they lived in the same villages in harmony, and they intermarried with each other, okay? Because they knew that they came from the same nation. They knew that they came from the Middle East, okay? They knew that they were Hebrews. How do we know that? When we go far back into time and read into the antiquities of the Cherokees, there's a man by the name of Daniel Sabin Buttrick. He was a missionary from 1817 and other missionaries to 1847 who dwelt among the Cherokees and recorded their lifestyle and their customs, just like a journalist will record what takes place in a catastrophic event. And this information was published by this company, Vanita Indian Chieftain Publisher, pertaining to the records of this so-called Reverend Daniel Sabin Buttrick, missionary from the 1700s, the recordings which he wrote concerning the Cherokee's customs. And this is what he wrote. He said, during some of their prayers, they raised their hands, just like King David, just like Abraham, to the first and second and third, fourth, fifth, and sixth, seventh heaven, and expressed their desire to the Creator, which they call the Great Spirit, who dwells there. But when they sung that special prayer designed for the morning of every seventh day, which is a Sabbath day, they commence with the third heaven. Check that out. Ascending to the fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and then uttered their prayer to the Father, meaning the Creator, which they call the Great Spirit, and the Son, which is the King of Kings. Check that out. This is in the Antiquities of the Cherokees. In substance as follows. This is what they say, the Cherokees. The past Cherokees, our past ancestors, because they were very spiritual before they fell. O God, meaning Creator, the Most High, thou hast created us, and thou hast the hearts of all in thy hands. We pray for thine aid and for long life and health, Aqua, which means Abraham. So they spoke about Abraham, and they say, Aqua, Abraham, our father, taught us to pray this. This is recorded in the Antiquities of the Cherokees, the past Cherokees, not the one current here today, because they're under a curse of being brainwashed like many other tribes today. Let's rewind the tape back and let's read that one more time, my brothers and sisters. It said, Aqua, Aqua. What does that sound like? It sound like broken down Hebrew. Aqua, Abraham, which means Abraham, our fathers taught us to pray thus. Now here's a picture of a so-called Cherokee brother. Most of y'all might be familiar with this image here today. Now, like I said before, this is coming out of what they call the Antiquities of the Cherokees. Now we got to keep in mind, like I said before, we're going back to past generations that were not so mentally destroyed like this present generation here today. And what has happened is recorded in Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 28. The Creator shall smite thee with madness and blindness inside the mind, inside the subconsciousness, and astonishment of heart for being disobedient against his commandments. Now, before, if any, you condemn this information, the wise, humble thing to do is to do some humble investigation, like it says in the book of Proverbs, chapter 14, verse 15. The simple believe every word, because we've been taught to believe every word that has been taught to us in these schools, which is nothing but an institution of brainwashism. The simple believe every word. Well, this is what the wise woman and wise man would do. But the prudent, meaning the intelligent, the wise, the humble, the meek. But the prudent man looketh well to his going. In other words, he or she will say, well, where do you get that information from? How do you know that? What is your reference? Where can I find this information? Instead of saying, nah, that's a bunch of lies. Because that's what this world is dealing with. Total ignorance, stupidity. Because 99% of the things that we've been taught is supreme garbage. Not regular garbage, supreme garbage. St. John chapter 8:32, ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Because we're not free inside the mind. A lot of us in slavery to arrogant, satanic, demonic pride. A lot of us are enslaved to a whole bunch of lies. And by the way, this is another one of our sisters, what they call the Kiowa sister, which is a descendant of Abraham's seed. And this picture that we was looking at before, I didn't mention it. This represents our Apache brothers, okay, going through a ceremony, celebrating when an Apache young sister transformed from a girl into a woman. Here's another photograph of one of our Native American brothers. Now, this is before. Now, we're saying this for understanding's sake. Now, this is what came after. This is an offspring of the invasion and the rape. I'm not saying this to fight with people, because when they explain situation and circumstances, we notice they leave out a lot of information, which is leading people to deception. Like it says in Lamentation chapter 5, verse 11, they ravish, mean to rape, the woman in Zion, and the maids, meaning virgins, in the cities of Judah. You see, let's deal with intelligence and understanding. This is a stock of European stock. This is more of the original stock before the invasions, before the so-called Native American Indians lost the 50 states. The truth is the truth. This is the issue of the matter. And you got a lot of the European stock mistreating the original stock, because I've been at some of these reservations, like the one up in the Hamptons. That's upstate New York in the Hamptons, okay? I was speaking to some of the ones that I could talk to, the so-called Shinnecock brothers, and they stated to me that the government gave the European stock X amount of dollars, and the European stock wouldn't even give one penny or dime to the brothers. Same situation go with the Mexicans, like the one that live in Veracruz, like this picture that we're looking at right now, which they suppress these images, the original brothers and sisters of Abraham's seed. Same thing is going on in Dominican Republic. Okay, so-called light skin versus dark skin, and then you got all this ignorant tribal conflict. Puerto Ricans don't like Dominicans, and Jamaicans don't like so-called Afro-Americans, and Cherokees don't like so-called Afro-Americans, and the so-called Afro-American woman is, some of them, not all, is jealous of the Brazilian sister's beauty. Well, by the way, this is one of our Dominican sisters. We do love our people, but the Most High got a message that he want to convey to us all, because the one we call God is getting real sick and tired of our ignorance and the way we mistreat each other. And all this nonsense, thinking we better than each other. We can believe whatever we want to believe in. But the one we call God said this in Amos chapter 9, verse 10. And all the sinners of my people shall die by the sword. And he's shown us his signs in the earthquakes and the hurricanes. And this is nothing to ignore. This is a message coming from the one we call God. because he's sick and tired of the Dominicans' strife with the Haitians, or the Haitian strife with the Dominicans. And he's going to end all of this one day. And there's going to be a whole lot of dead people of our nation, okay, that refuse to repent and change their ways. Now, by the way, this is our Haitian family, because you got evil Haitian brothers and sisters, and you got brothers and sisters that's from Haiti that's not trying to be evil. You got Dominican brothers and sisters that's wicked, and you got Dominican brothers and sisters that are not trying to be wicked. You got so-called Afro-American, so-called black man and black woman that's wicked, and you got some that's not trying to be wicked. Cherokee Indians, so on and so forth. Like it says in the book of Jeremiah chapter 5, verse 26, which explains this matter as well. For among my people are found wicked men. Okay, but that don't mean everybody is wicked. Then some of you tribes be teaching your kids that the so-called Afro-American, not all of you tribes, but for those who this pertain to, because we got to speak the truth, the so-called Afro-American, so-called black man and black woman, you paint this picture in their mind like everybody that's over here in America is wicked. That's a lie. That's not true. That's falsehood. Okay, that would be like me saying that every Dominican brother or sister or Puerto Rican or Panamanian or Cuban or Mexican, that would be like me saying all of them are lesbians and homosexuals. And that's not true. Or all of them smoke drugs. And that's not true. Or all of them do cocaine or take angel dust or commit adultery. That is not true. We got to use wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, okay, and think before we react, because we're going to be judged by the very thoughts that we think evil against each other. And the one we call God is going to punish us, just like it says in Colossians chapter 3:25, he that doeth wrong, the wrong he shall receive. Such is the situation: we commit adultery, we sleep with another man's wife, we shoot each other down and kill each other like dogs, we murder each other, we abuse each other, we use each other. Some of us, we sodomize our sons and we rape our daughters, and some of us kill and suffocate our sons and daughters and throw them in the garbage can. And we're going to be judged for this. We're going to be charged for this. But returning back to our Hebrew heritage, here's some more of our princess sisters of our nation at this carnival located in what they call South America, in the area, I think it's called Uruguayan. But let's put the camera into reverse and let's reflect on this book called Israelites and Jews, pertaining to a statement that was made pertaining to the brothers and sisters that live in Haiti, who are known as so-called Haitians, and the brothers and sisters that were living in New Orleans. And it states this. It says, Blair Niles, author of Black Haiti, writes, some were said to be descendants of Hebrews. Okay, this so-called Jewish term is something that's modern. That's not the real interpretation. Speaking of the slaves in Haiti, Reverend H.S. Whitehead said concerning the slaves in the Virginian Islands, on the door of the Negro cabinets in the country, crosses may be seen much like those the Hebrews made with the blood of the Passover lamb. And the Haitians, so-called Haitians, are also our relatives, even though some of their minds are destroyed. But the Most High is going to wake up some of the Haitian brothers and sisters, okay, that's speaking the patois, rather the French language, for the ones that he shall select. Let's go to some more testimonies pertaining to our heritage. This came from a book titled The Indian Slave Trade by the author Alan Galley. Okay, this is another European man that settled among what they call the Amerindians, just like a journalist. And this is what he recorded, what he saw, and what he heard. It said, at one Indian festival held near the Glebe land, he rejoiced to learn that his Amerindian neighbors believed that man was created, which is Genesis 1:26, first, and woman from his rib. At a Etowah festival, an Indian, so-called Indian, related a story similar to that of Noah and the Ark. And this is also recorded in the Antiquity of the Cherokees, pertaining to the flood. Like James Adair, a Carolina trader of the next generation who also settled among the so-called Native American Indians, and he recorded their customs as well. And he came to the same conclusion. He wrote a book about the North American Indians that attempt to prove they were descendants from the lost tribes of Israel. Let's continue, which he did. That fellow name is James Adair. Some of you may know about him. Moreover, for Lee Jah, the truth of the biblical stories seem confirmed when recited by Indians. How else could Indians, so-called Indians, have learned the stories except from what they call God, meaning the Creator, unless they were descendants of the 10 lost tribes? That was prophesied in the book of 2 Ezra chapter 13, verse 40, that would migrate over to what they call North America. The so-called North American Indians, I repeat, were one of those tribes, descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel. 2 Ezra chapter 13, verse 40, once again. These are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their land in the time of Hosea, the king who Salmaneser, the king of Assyria, led away captive, and he carried them over the waters, and so came they in another land. Now, how did this European man knew about such situation that's recorded in 2 Ezra chapter 13, verse 40 and 41 down? Because they knew about the prophecy, and they knew there wasn't no so-called Native American Indians, because there is no such people. Let's read Lee Jah's statement once again, who was living near the so-called Native American Indians for some dispensation of time. It said, moreover, for Lee Jah, the truth of the biblical story seems confirmed when recited by the Indians, so-called. How else could Indians have learned the stories except from the Great Spirit, the Creator, unless they were descendants of the 10 lost tribes? Also in the Antiquity of the Cherokees, it makes mention of this also about the Cherokees. You find the name Yahawah, just like in their so-called Indian chants. Yahawah, Yah. Those are all Hebraic pronunciations. Yah and Ha and Wah, those are all Hebraic alphabets. And you hear those same chants inside their in their ceremonies when they used to do the rain dance and so on and so forth. So in the Antiquities of the Cherokees, it says Yahawah was the name of a king who lived a great while ago. He was a man, and yet his spirit, a God, meaning the Most High Creator of the universe, a very glorious being. His name was never to be spoken in common talk, just like the rules and regulations and the commandments that was given to Moses to give to the 12 tribes of Israel. Exodus 20, verse 7, thou shalt not take the name of the Most High power in vain, for the Most High will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain. This is also recorded in the Antiquities of the Cherokees, and it states that the Most High name is never to be spoken in common talk. This great king commanded, talking about the Creator of the universe, them to rest every seventh day, as Exodus chapter 20, verse 8 records. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work. Like I said before, my brothers and sisters, let me reiterate. This is way before they were conquered, okay, and destroyed. Way before their woman was raped, way before their babies was killed, way before they was put on these things called reservations, which is nothing but concentration camp. They were following the customs of the ancient Mosaic order. Why is that? This is way before they was brainwashed by force into this fake thing called religion. Why were they following Mosaic customs? Okay, this is way before they were taken down, because they were descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel. and they maintain these customs of their heritage until other generations rose up after them and they lost their customs as it is today. Like it says right here, let us continue. It said, this great king commanded them to rest every seventh day, which is the Sabbath day when the Most High Creator completed creating this universe, and told them, talking about the Creator, that if they should work on that day, the Sabbath day, they should die, or some of their relatives. Just like it states in Exodus chapter 20, verse 9, 6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work. 10th verse, for the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Most High Creator of the universe. In it thou shalt not do any work, nor thy son, nor thy daughters, thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor thy strangers that is within thy gates. Let us continue with the Hebrew heritage and the recordings of the antiquities of the Cherokees. They were to hold their hands still, the palms up, and their talk must be about the Most High, Yahweh, Sikh, was most sacred name. None must speak it but persons appointed for the purpose, and they only on Sabbath. The Most High created the world in 7 days. That is so beautiful and that is so clear. Our so-called Cherokee family, as this picture here demonstrates. Let's read this statement at the very bottom of this picture. It says, Cherokees, so-called, had thousands of black members, most of whom had been introduced to the nation as slaves by whites seeking to make bondage universal. But many of the wise Cherokee brothers, they didn't go along with this madness. But we did have some evil within all these tribes, whether Cherokee, whether so-called Negroes, so on and so forth. But there was always a small remnant that had true, sincere, brotherly love and sisterly love for our nation. Here we see some more of our relatives here today scattered on the northern coastline of Ecuador. And this area is known as Esmeraldas. That's right, on the northern coast of Ecuador, South America. And on this northern coast, you have what they call our relatives, so-called Afro-American community, fulfilling the prophecy of Deuteronomy chapter 29, verse 28, temporarily. And the Most High rooted them out of their land in anger and in wrath and in great indignation, and cast them into another land as it is today. Now, the prophecy of Deuteronomy chapter 29, verse 28 speaks about us being rooted out of our land, and Ecuador is one of those land. And the land that we was rooted out was what they call Jerusalem. Now, we know that's going to be pretty hard for a lot of our brothers and sisters to digest and understand, because our minds has been contaminated and we have been separated so long from our true ancient biblical heritage. But in due process, the supreme being of the universe shall restore our thoughts into its proper correct capacity. Now, this is supposed to be a testament, or rather testimony, coming from a Missouri so-called Cherokee tribes proclaiming Hebrew heritage, my brothers and sisters. And it states this, by the staff, February 7, 2003. And it states, the Northern Cherokee Nation, okay, of old Louisiana, which they once dwelt, territory has recently shocked the world by claiming their ancient oral legend tell of a Cherokee migration made to America from the area known as Masada. Now, if you know anything about the location of Masada, you're talking about west of the Dead Sea, southeast of Jerusalem, which is known today as the Middle East, Palestine. You can look this up on your internet. Missouri Cherokee Tribe proclaims Jewish heritage, rather Hebraic heritage. Just to put things in their proper perspective, this report also claims North Up, okay, which is a spokesman representative by the name of Beverly Baker for this these Cherokee Brothers and Sisters organization. And this report also states, North Up claims that the famous scholar Josephus wrote that there were escapes from Masada in the Middle East, in which the spokesman, Beverly Baker, for the Northern Cherokee states that this is evidence that gives credence to this connection between the Cherokee Indians and the Hebrews. The proper term is Hebrews, not Jews. That's something that was made up around the 17th century, the letter J. In addition to other startling claims, that there's also belief by the Northern Cherokee that a rock that was uncovered in Tennessee in 1889 that is named the Bat Creek Stone proves a transatlantic connection to Hebrews. North Up believe that the scratch writings on the rock indicate that the stone is evidence of a first century Atlantic crossing to America by these escaped Hebrews that later became known as the Northern Cherokee Indians. The reason why the report said they became later known as Cherokees because their original identity was stripped from them, which was Hebrews. Now here's that what they call Bat Creek Stone, which was discovered in 1889, okay, in Easton, Tennessee, okay, by the Smithsonian Mount Survey Project, which they have, okay, located in the back room of the Natural Museum of History, okay, located in Washington, D.C., and it reads the word Judea. Either the so-called Cherokees carved this in when they came over here, or rather they brought this over from the Middle East to Eastern Tennessee on their travels, because they were descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. This is just clear. Of course, many people will deny it. Even the generation of the Cherokees here today probably will deny it, because they lacking biblical true understanding of their heritage, and it is a spiritual curse that came upon our souls for disrespecting the Most High, just like the Mayans when they were cutting the heads of their brothers off and worshiping the sun and all the other tribal conflicts. That's what brought us down to this low level. You see, we can talk about this heritage of our nation, such as the so-called Native American Indians. We can show their pictures that they were sisters and brothers of color, but we also must talk about, also for reminder's sake, okay, what did we do to get inside this situation, and what must we do to get out of this situation, my brothers and sisters, because the one that created us is very upset with us, and this has to be announced too as well. You see, we can show you this testament of Spaniards and that testament of another Spaniards, all confirming that we were descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel. We can also show you that the rock that they found in Mexico, which had many Hebrew alphabets written on them, that was decoded in 1949 by this man named Robert H. P. Pfeffer. And when he decoded it, it read the Ten Commandments. And the brothers and sisters that they classify as the Almecs was living in this land of Mexico way before the Spaniard invasion. And they was fully aware, okay, of this rock that had Hebrew alphabets written all over it, okay, reading the Ten Commandments that's recorded in Exodus chapter 20, verse 13, for an example, thou shalt not kill thy brethren, because they were descendants of the seed of Abraham, and they migrated from what they call Jerusalem to what they call Western America. So we're going to touch on just a few more key pointers pertaining to our Hebrew heritage, and then we shall move on into the situation pertaining to What did we do to get in this situation, and what must we do to get out of this situation? Just like it says in the book of Romans, chapter 15, verse 4, whatsoever things were written aforetime, meaning past times, were written for our learning, to learn from the mistakes of our ancient forefathers and to learn from the mistakes of the people in the world here today. Like it says in 1 Corinthians, chapter 15, verse 2, by which also ye are saved if ye keep in memory what I preach unto you, unless ye have believed in vain. And what was the preaching of the prophets? Because all you brothers and sisters of my nations, of these different tribes, through the course of history, the one we call God, the creator of the universe, the great spirit, he used to send prophets to tell us and to warn us of our evil, unless the one we call God, the great spirit, the most high creator of the universe, that he would punish us and bring judgment on us in a way that we could not imagine, which we shall expound on shortly. Now, this came from the book titled The Native American Lead of the Iroquois, so-called Indians, by the author named Lewis Henry Morgan. Now, check this out, my brothers and sisters. Okay. What we have right here is showing basically the Our Father prayer that the so-called Iroquois Native American Indian brothers used to say, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Now, when you look at the very top, it says, Guani chi de or, jo ya je, jasenu. That's broken down Hebrew. Why would the Iroquois, so-called Native American Indians, quoting the Our Father prayer that's recorded in the book of Matthew chapter 6, because they were descendants of the seed of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the children of Israel, other known as Yasha'Allah. Now, this next photograph we're dealing with is dealing with our brothers and sisters that's living in Puerto Rico. Like it says, the historical photo of Puerto Ricans from the library, okay, of the U.S. Congress. Just like it states in the book of Acts, chapter 3:25, ye are the children of the prophets of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the children of Israel, and of the covenant which the Most High, the one you call God, made with our fathers, saying unto Abraham, in thy seed, which you are that seed, just like I am that seed, shall all the kindreds of the earth be blessed. Unto you first, after the curse of our judgment is finally completed. You see? These are our relatives. This is our ancestors. This is an old portrait of the so-called Puerto Rican brothers who are descendants of the seed of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, not Africans, because the Africans are totally two different people than we are. We come from the seed of Shem. They come out of the bloodline of Ham. That's the deception of this false education. Let's focus on just a few more facts, and then we shall proceed to move on. Why we fell into this situation and what is the solution? This is called Bernard Chagan. And the statement states this because he spoke the truth. Bernard de Chagan was one of the very first preachers of New Spain, Mexico. He was also a Franciscan Spaniard who spent 60 years among the Indians, so-called Indians. Let us continue. One of the many facts the Franciscan had brought out in his history book, in the support, okay, of the Aztecs being one of the lost tribes of Israel, was that Montezuma, who was the king at one point of the Aztecs himself, and here's an illustrated picture of King Montezuma of the Aztecs trying to advise his brothers not to attack, okay, the Spaniards when Hernan Cortes took Montezuma as a hostage, who was eventually injured by his own tribal brethren. Let's continue. It says, Montezuma himself, king, okay, of the Aztecs, at the arrival of Hernan Cortes, Spanish conquistadors, the Spaniard military, which was sent by Isabella, had related to him the fact that his ancestors, this is what Montezuma said to Hernan Cortes. He said, the fact that his ancestors came from the East, the Middle East, Jerusalem, and that is not East New York or Eastern Parkway. Let us continue. It says in 1512, Pope Julius II proclaimed that the Indians were the children of Adam and Eve. You see, that goes right back to the Hebrew bloodline of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. It's nothing to be ashamed about our true heritage. It's just that a lot of us are acting like fools and the Most High gonna deal with us. So let us conclude on these two tokens, my brothers and sisters. Why are we catching so much hell? Why are we going through this? What did we do? Why did the great spirit, the creator of the universe, allow Custer Douglas to destroy and kill our Native American Indian brothers, their wives, and their little sons and their daughters? Why did the Most High allow the Aztec Empire to be destroyed by the Spaniards? Why did the creator of the universe allow our past ancestors, male and female, the so-called Negro woman and man, to be yoked up, choked up, hanged up, and strangled up in hardcore assassination slavery? And the answer to the reason why this has happened to us, our whole entire nation, and the Tainos, my brothers and sisters, is recorded in the book of Ezekiel, chapter 39, verse 22. We know a lot of brothers and sisters will not accept this, but this is the true issue of the matter. There's something we did against the one that created us, whether we want to hear it or not. And it states this, my brothers and sisters, Ezekiel, chapter 39, verse 22. So the house of Israel, which represents you and me, South America, so-called Negroes, so-called Jamaican and Haitian, so-called Brazilian sisters and brothers, so-called Afro-Ecuadorians, Colombians, Cubans, Mexicans, Venezuela, so on and so forth, so-called Native American Indians. So the house of Israel, my so-called Ecuadorian brothers and sisters, shall know that I am the Most High, their power, from that day and forward. And the heathen, the other nations that took us in captivity, shall know that the house of Israel went into captivity for their iniquity. What iniquity? Such as that Aztec evil generation who used to rip the hearts out of the physical body of their brethren to worship the sun and also chop their heads off. And the heathen shall know that the house of Israel went into captivity for their iniquity because they transgressed against me. The me is talking about the one that created us, the Most High Supreme Being. And this is another one of those transgressions against the one that created us, because the Most High Creator of the universe gave us rules and regulations to live by. As Leviticus chapter 11, verse 44 states how the Most High told us to be ye holy, for I am holy. We were supposed to be an example to the other nations, but we have reduced ourselves to a degenerate level. Another crime that we committed against the Most High Creator of the universe is this thing, witchcraft, these rituals, these spells, this so-called Santa Maria, which we inherit these same crimes that some of our forefathers were doing. And some of us are cutting chicken heads off, shaking the chicken blood, trying to cast evil spells and hex on the other people of our nation up until this very hour. I'm not saying that this Ecuadorian princess that we're looking at here today is one of those victims of such circumstances, but this is the reason why we are on the bottom temporarily. Now the works of the flesh are manifested, which are these: adultery, still sleeping with another man's wife, fornication, sleeping around with a whole bunch of women like a bunch of dogs, uncleanness, lasciviousness, 20th verse, idolatry, some of us are still worshiping stupid idols, and witchcraft. Some of us are witches and warlocks. Hatred, and we bear hatred against the people of our nation. Variance, emulations, wrath. We execute wrath against each other like some of the Indian tribes executed bloodshed against certain tribes in the past, such as the so-called Indian tribe known as the Assiniboines, shooting and gunning down the so-called Cheyenne tribe over a buffalo dispute, just like it says in Isaiah 59, verse 2. But your iniquities have separated between you and your power. Third verse, for your hands are defiled with blood. That goes for the so-called Negro, Afro-American Negro man as well as Jamaican, Puerto Rican, Haitian, Panamanian, Cubans, Mexicans, so on and so forth. And also this crime of abortion and also the worshiping of our dead ancestors. We are following the way of the beast, as Leviticus chapter 21 states. And the Most High said unto Moses, speak unto the priests, the sons of Aaron, and say unto them, there shall none be defiled for the dead among his people. This so-called ancestral worship is wicked. It's going all the way back to the simple Egyptian empire, where they used to worship stupid, simple, dead corpse mummies. We are to respect and honor the righteous ancestors, but we are not to worship them with this ancestral worship, like the Most High said in Romans 1:25, how we serve the creature and not the creator, which makes the one that created us very mad, because this is dishonor. But the solution here is for us to get on our knees and be remorseful and sorry to the Most High for the things that we have done. Like it says in Matthew chapter 4, verse 17, from that time, the King of Kings began to preach and say, repent, for the kingdom of the Most High is at hand. And what many people may define as corny, such as repentance, is a life and death matter, because the one that created us has predicted and he has ordained a day where he shall free us from such suffering, circumstances, and situation. But we must repent and change our evil ways for the time of true justice and judgment against the wicked is at hand. And we want to make sure we're not on the Most High Creator's judgment assassination list. Seek to reconcile with your Creator before it's too late. May the Spirit of the Most High Almighty Father illuminate your mind and protect you and your family until the very end. My brothers and sisters, we love you, brothers and sisters in South America, and we consider your suffering and your pain. And one day, your day of redemption from these slum shanty towns shall one day come to an end. And I'll be so glad for you as well as me. Peace and blessings. May the Most High protect you and be with you, my brothers and sisters in South America. We love you always to the very, very end.
Basic fundamentals pertaining to our heritage, pertaining to our family throughout North America, South America, as well as so this is a great Native American.
That's why we went to slavery.
This is not for those who already know. This is basically for those who don't.
Rebelliousness rule our physical temple. We have extreme hatred for the Creator, rules and regulations and principles. The Creator gave man and woman rules to live by. We broke the everlasting code of the fiery, biblical tongue covenant. Yes, our ignorance, disobedience, our wickedness has brought us down into the dirty slum bum level. This is a curse from the womanhood sacrifice. Long dress code, head wraps and veils, yes. Reduced to insanity, stinking blood corruption. Sex used to be sacred. Some sisters sleep around with 10 men in one night, yes. And now we follow garbage and eat garbage, and we became garbage. The Most High has made the woman rebel against the man. Understand, this is a curse, curse.
We have rebelled against the Most High. That's why we went into slavery.
The mystery. From the big power, because we gave disrespect to the Creator for many years. Yes, the woman used to be the man's glory. The man is the Creator glory. This ain't no story or allegory. No more being meekness and kind and humble. Yes, now your wife is a walking, talking big butcher knife. The Lord has turned her into the dragon, the five fingers of death in your face. This is our punishment and our judgment. We used to sacrifice our sons and daughters to the devil and burn them up on the fire and cut out their hearts in demonic temples. This is the real true history of you and me. Now we sleep with a violin under the bed sheets. This is a curse. The Most High cursed us because we are rebellious.
We have rebelled against the Most High. That's why we went into slavery. We have rebelled against the Most High. That's why we went into slavery. We have rebelled against the Most High. That's why we went into slavery.
That's why the Lord allowed us to go in slavery.
We have rebelled against the Most High.
The tender and delicate woman,
whose foot adventure once not to touch the earth, yes, once delicate, tender, and sweetness. Her eyeballs shall be evil towards her husband. Her eyeballs shall be evil towards her husband. Of her bosom, 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 and towards her sons and her daughters. Yes, slap the slack, slack the louder. It's time to slap the slack cloth. Slack, 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 slack. Time to slap the slack, slack, the sack cloth on your body and cry to the power on your knees. Yeah, G. And say, Lord, power, please redeem me from the Babylonian dragon curse. Yes, I repent to respect you. Rules and regulation, no more being satanic.
We have rebelled against the Most High. That's why we went into slavery. We have rebelled against the Most High. That's why we went into slavery. We have rebelled against the Most High.
That's why we don't have our own land.
That's why we went into slavery.
That's why we don't live under our very own constitution.
We have rebelled against